you know, other than the matches, and it just feels like a cop-out when it's just nonstop three-way matches, just like it does with AEW. WWE needs to be called that for it, too. It feels like a cop-out on these shows when that's all you see. Let's just get everyone out there in multi-man matches. Beyond that, the angles on this show, the promos on this show, this is a good wrestling show, and considering the week it happened, that all of this happened, not just with AEW having that record low rating, but they did an angle to end this show where the baby faces were completely beat down by a new crazy heel in the top heel stable, as opposed to Raw, which this week ended with a new supernatural heel stable killing the roster. I said to you the other day, I wish there was a zone in WWE safe from that kind of stuff. Hopefully SmackDown will be, because this is an example of what could be a great SmackDown.
See, we like the werewolf better than the Wyatts, because the werewolf is not actually a fucking werewolf.
His face, just whoa, when they were doing the close-ups of his face, he looks like a maniac. This is going to be great.
That's how you make an impact with people. That's how you get a new talent over. They've got to come out and show what they... And, you know, again, between how much you think they spent for Jacob Fatu and how much you think Tony spent for Okoede or for Will Ostrich.
Well, here's the big question, and I don't even think you could talk about Okada in this sense because, whether you like him or not, he's kind of a non-entity there right now. But Ospreay, there's something there. Who's more over, though? Ospreay's like super over with that fan. Well, super over. He's over enough that the people that are there are into him, but no one's coming out extra. But not just Jacob Fatu, first night in. Even Tama Tonga. He was kind of not one of those names coming out of New Japan that people talked about. I've seen the reactions he's gotten on these shows. He's more over, certainly, than Okada is with the AEW fans, I think.
Well, yeah, and the thing is, it's, again, it's not necessarily all talent. It's not all the talent of the individual. It's how they are presented. It has to be both. And the point I was making with how much did these guys cost Tony versus how much they probably signed Jacob Fatu for, because he never been on television. I'm sure they didn't rape him or anything. I give him a field hand contract, for heaven's sake. But,
and by the way, Tony could have had him at any point if he really wanted him.
Of course. That's what I was saying from the start with Tony 5 years ago. He's a billionaire. When you don't have restrictions on how much money you could spend, why are you using substandard indie outlaw talent that's not ready for a major television production? And the point is, in 2 minutes, they made Jacob Fatu, who didn't cost millions of dollars, have a bigger impact and get over to a wider audience than they did in AEW with Okoede and with Will and with Mercedes. And it didn't cost nearly as much. The returns are immense because it's how you present it. He came off as a dominant, dangerous individual, and the other people come out and have mediocre to okay wrestling matches. In Mercedes's case, not that. And in a couple of their cases, the promos are the shits too. And it took Will 15 or 20 minutes to beat everybody I've seen him in the ring with. So that's the difference. You want to make a star, he's got to look like a star, and he's got to act like a star. And they made a star with Jacob Fatu, and they've elevated these other guys also because they've taken people that the fan base had no preconceived notion of because they hadn't seen them before, and they presented them as top individuals to watch out for, and everything they're involved with makes enough sense, and they interact with other main event level talent that people know. So boom, that's what they are. Or they can come out and be competitive with fucking underneath middle card and unknown guys for 20 minutes and wander around twisting in the wind on promos because they don't know enough to do their own. And that's what you get there.
What if Roman comes back and pleads with these baby faces to help him, the ones that were attacked here, and he uses it to turn on Cody. Trick him the same way Dusty was tricked.
No, because then you ruin Roman.
See, that's the other question. Do you think Roman is more valuable as a babyface, or do you think, even with all the chance and everything, his true value, especially if he's going to work this kind of schedule, is as a heel?
Well, his value is as a babyface because the people want him back so bad, and they're setting up that these other people have usurped his throne. But you wouldn't have him come back in an angle specifically to turn on Cody, because then if he joined these other motherfuckers, then you got like six of them. Well, then the same thing, the problem they're going to have with the Wyatts. How many top fucking baby faces are you going to tie up trying to fight these fuckers? And it would piss people off because Roman had heat. They wanted Roman's reign to come to an end. And it did, but now other people have replaced him in terms of the people that the fans have heat with, and they're wanting to see Roman come back and straighten it out. He needs to come back and at least attempt to, in good faith, straighten it out, and then a year down the road after that, maybe. But then, by that point, he's making movies or whatever he's doing anyway. But he needs to come back and be a babyface if they're going to do this.
Again, if he's doing that, this is one of those things like, you know, Shane Douglas is going to be a doctor that we've been hearing for a while. Roman Reigns is going to go make movies. There haven't been any movies yet.
Shane was going to be a doctor, wasn't he?
Remember that used to be like, you know, I don't need the business. I can go be a doctor.
Then why'd he end up working at Walmart?
Let's leave him alone. Pick on Shane kind of thing.
Well, I'm just saying, how do you go from doctor to doctor of Walmart, ECW. Nevertheless.
ECW.
Well, there we go. Go back to the biography.